Hi, I'm Coach Corey Wayne, and this is my video coaching newsletter. And the topic of today's newsletter is going to be, should you have a wingman when you go out, or should you fly solo? I got an email here from a guy who's asking me that very question, coincidentally. What a coinkydink. He says, hi Corey, I just came across your video today, and I was just browsing through YouTube watching some How to Be Charming videos. I got hooked on your videos straight away, and what you say, and I appreciate. Thanks for your energy and wisdom. I have a question. I have those nights where I want to go out, but no one else wants to come out with me. Some of my friends and people comment that flying solo makes you look like a loser. Now I want to break this myth, and I know that if I go flying solo, my main aim is to make new friends and be charming so that they want to hang out with them. Is that right? Abso-fucking-lutely. My attitude and the way I like things, I actually like to fly solo. For the most part, I always fly solo when I'm going through life just being me. Because I don't have let's face it. If you've been following my work for a while, you've probably shared it with some of your friends, and you may have found that most of them are not open to this kind of stuff, or they're like, yeah, I need to read that. I need to read that guy's book. Yeah, I really need help in that area. You know they need help, and they know they need help, but will they do anything to help themselves? Probably fucking not. That's what I found over the years. You know, I have a lot of friends that I went to high school with that I talk to and then I know read my stuff, but you know, it's like for the most part, like my inner circle, my close friends, it's most of them that just, they don't want, they're just not interested in that kind of thing. They've got too many excuses or stories or whatever, and they know it would help them, but they're just simply not going to do it. And so if you're focusing on, like, relentlessly reading about this stuff and applying it, what's going to happen is you're going to really start to advance quickly. And if you've got friends that are, like, lagging behind and they just fucking won't get a clue, and so it's like every time you take them out with you, they just fucking cock block you, it's like, fucking see you later. It's, you know, invite them to go hang out with somebody else, because that's what I learned. I mean, I you know, it was funny. One of the guys that used to work for me years ago, because I've always been into personal growth and personal development, he said to me, he said, Corey, he said, you're just a much faster swimmer than the rest of us. And so if you're watching this video, there's a very good chance that your friends and your family say the same kind of shit about you. You're usually the first one to read the new book or the new manual or try the new technique or the new exercise program or whatever the fuck it happens to be, the latest technology. You're just always one of the guys that's out there kind of like 10 years ahead of everybody else, you know. And so what I've realized that it's just, you know, a lot easier just to go out with by myself. And like, especially like I love traveling. You know, like if I don't have a girl with me, I fucking love to travel by myself because I never know who the hell I'm going to meet. And if you got a wingman that their skills aren't as good as yours, they're actually going to be like a giant boat anchor around your neck. And so it's better for them not to be there. And I have a great time when I go out. You know, if I go out with a bunch of friends to a bar or a nightclub occasionally, I'm going out because I just want to hang out with my buddies and have fun. And if we meet women along the way, which we always do, just because we're always having a ridiculous, outrageous time, then great. That's a benefit. You know, it's a bonus. It's gravy. But, you know, I don't go out looking to meet women because, you know, my attitude is that when you go out looking to meet women, you're basically showing up already saying that, you know, I ain't fucking getting no pussy and, you know, girls don't like me and I'm not very successful with women. And you put that energy out there and women see it. They sense it. They can look at you and can tell that you're not very successful with women. But the guys that are successful with women or who are taken, they're usually the ones that are having a great time. They usually have a group of people around them. And so, like, when I go with my buddies, there may be just two or three of us, but within 10 to 15 minutes, there might be 10 people around us. And if you watch our group long enough, you'll notice that there's lots of people that seem to kind of come and go through the group, especially women. And you know, what you realize is that it's because of the energy that we emanate, it's people see that and they gravitate towards that and they come on over. But if you don't have friends that are like that and you know, you're out on your own, you just go out and it's all about making friends. And if you practice this stuff, whether you're standing in line at the grocery store or the gas station or standing in line at a hostess stand waiting to get sat at a restaurant, you put yourself in the mindset where you're always just talking and interacting with people wherever you go. And just occasionally you're going to turn around and you're like, and there's going to be a super fucking smoking hot woman that walked in behind you and you just didn't even notice it. And since you do it all the time and you talk to people wherever you go, you're like, hey, what's happening? It's like, well, you fucking snuck in here like a fucking ninja. Where'd you come from? Were you sneaking up behind me? You're going to pick my pocket or something? Or just fuck with her. Say whatever. And if she's got a good attitude or a good sense of humor and she likes you, she's going to think it's funny. If she's got a shitty attitude, she's going to look at you like that was the dumbest thing you ever said. And it might have been, but who fucking cares? That's the point, is that you can't give a shit. And so the idea is you go about your life and you're happy with who you are and you just shoot the shit about whatever it happens to be. If you're standing, like I say, it's like if you're standing in line, you know, I always like making a joke about, you know, something that's the opposite. It's like if there's a giant line, well, it's obviously not the fucking express line. And so I'll make a joke about something like that. Or like, well, I'm glad I got in the short line, or, you know, I'm glad I got in the express line, or I'm glad I got in the VIP line. That way I don't have to wait. You know, and people will laugh at that because they're thinking and they're feeling the same exact fucking thing. Like, why the hell did I get in this fucking line? But that's just what making small talk is all about. And if a woman's giving you some indicators that she may be interested by standing too close or touching you, or she just laughs at every stupid thing that comes out of your mouth, then you make a date on the spot. You know, that's the best way to go about it. And so the way I look at it, wingmen or no wingmen, I prefer not to have wingmen, especially if you got guys that are friends of yours that just won't do what it takes. You know, you give them advice, but, you know, it's like, you know, they just won't get it. It's better to go out on your own and try it, you know, because I guarantee you, if you got the right attitude and you have no problem talking to people, you're going to make a lot of friends and you don't have to worry about getting fucking cock blocked. And plus, if you hook up with a chick, then you don't have to worry about driving your drunk buddy home. You can just go home with her. You can take her right back to your place. So if you find this message of value, you could show your appreciation by going to my website at understandingrelationships.com and click the PayPal donate button, which is located in the Wibia toolbar at the bottom of any page of my website, and donate any amount that you feel is equal to the value of the information in this video. At the very least, please share this video with all your friends and family by clicking any one of the social network sharing buttons, which are also located conveniently, thanks to YouTube, on the video. And if you'd like to send me a question or there's a topic you want me to cover in a future video newsletter, go to my website, understandingrelationships.com, click the Contact Me tab, and send me 3 or 4 paragraphs maximum detailing your situation. And you just got to give me several days to get back to you with a response, because I get a lot of email from the internet, and I also get a lot from my paying phone coaching customers. But just be patient and I will get back to you. And if you want to talk to me right away, if you want to book a paid phone coaching session with me personally, go to my website, understandingrelationships.com, and click the products tab and just follow the instructions. And I will talk to you soon.